see you. First of all, a word of apology. For those of you who are uncomfortable with differences from the norm, please forgive us for arranging the platform in this way with grandad here this morning. Because after the festival last night with Parable, which was a lovely evening, I don't think we could really face all the furniture removal that was necessary. So we thought we'd try this morning, and it may well suit the meeting today in any case. Second thing, if you've got Greg Davis's jacket, will you please surrender it? You'll know, because it's too big for you. So one, we have the altar service there. It's a rather full program this morning. So straight away, let's sing together. 575, give us a day of wonders, Jehovah, bear thine arms. Stand please to sing three verses straight away.
microphone down to our height. Flag behind you. has now arrived. And the colours are? Yellow, red and blue. And when you get a little older, and perhaps you might be thinking about becoming a senior soldier, not just a junior soldier as today, Uncle Mike there will still be there. And he'll be able to tell you what the colours of the flag mean. Because they're the same colours that are on your tie, aren't they? I don't suppose you will remember it today, but the blue stands for the purity of the Holy Spirit. The yellow stands for the fire of the Holy Spirit. And the red stands for the blood of Jesus. Whenever you see the army flag or a junior soldier wearing that tie, that's what it reminds us about. It reminds us that all who ask God for their forgiveness can be his loving and obedient child. And because Jesus is your Saviour, you can trust him to keep you good. And if you're that good, others will want to follow him because they will see Jesus in you. We're ever so glad that you promised to pray and to read your Bible and to lead a life that's clean in thought, word and deed. Now, Uncle Mike and Auntie Irene and the fact that are just three of all of these people who want to help you to be the best junior soldier that you can possibly be. But Christopher, you have a great advantage this morning. You come from a family which also loves Jesus. You come from a Christian family, a family that knows all about loving and serving Jesus. Wouldn't it be nice if all of the family were to come down here? Do you think it would? Would you like to invite them to come? Say, come and stand with me, family.
Come and stand with me, family.
Here come, please. All associated with girlfriends as well, love and serve you, and you have sent to us Christopher. We thank you for him and for the influence that he can be. We thank you for the sincerity of his promise, for the influence that undoubtedly will come from him. At this moment we surround him with not just the prayers of a congregation, we surround him with prayers of mother, father, brother, sister. We would ask, dear God, that as Christopher grows, he might not only grow in stature, but he will grow in spiritual stature. Grant to him the opportunities that will be needed to stretch his potential, that he might fulfill all the hopes that we have for him and the plans which you have laid for him. For we ask it in the name of Jesus. Amen. Christopher, I hope not to puncture you, but here is the junior soldier's badge. It says you're special to us because you're already special to God. I'm going to ask in a moment that you should sign your promise, and we're going to take you down to the Salvation Army Mercy Seat here to do that. Just bow your heads, please, again in prayer. If you would. Come with me, Christopher. Christopher is alone with God. But if we are to be a Christian congregation, Christopher must never feel that he is alone in his walk with God. His brothers and his sister, I charge you, not just to be a brother and sister to Christopher, but to be his friend. To be his companion along the Christian road. One day, I charge you in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ to be his example of Christianity. In your home, to make that place to be a sanctuary for Christopher to grow in. To love him, to nurture him in the faith, just as you promised when he was dedicated. One day, if the family would like to join Christopher now, so that he symbolically, from this point, is never alone on his Christian walk with the Lord. Join him, my passion. Christopher now receives the support of his family, openly, publicly. Having charged them with their responsibility, I now charge you, the congregation, this call, that you will receive Christopher as our newest soldier. And I charge you to be examples to him of Christ-likeness, that in all your actions and words, Christopher sees Jesus. In the name of the Lord, accept this charge. For now I give to you Christopher, junior soldier of the Chatham Citadel Salvation Army Corps. Please stand up, Christopher, turn around, see all these people who are now going to welcome you into the Corps. He's taking no chances with you. They want to give you the Book of Books. Presented to Christopher Michael with love from Mum, Dad, Andrew and Amy on this special day when you were enrolled as a junior soldier. Christopher, if you read that book from cover to cover, over and over again, it will teach you how to be the best junior soldier in the world. It's yours. Read it. God bless you. Bye-bye. Christopher's not empty.
Ring of love, night of suspicion. Heavenly Father, we thank you indeed for all the many gifts that are given to each one of us. We think of the gifts that have been given today and the gifts that have been given over these past 125 years for your service. We pray that as those gifts have been given, sometimes through suffering, sometimes through deep commitment, we pray that those gifts given today may be used similarly and taken forward, such that as the gospel has been proclaimed through this town over the past century, we may do so in the future.
I could think of enough favourite songs to fill a month of Sundays with their own memory and stories to tell. In fact, we've sung one already this morning, number 579. But I've only allowed one, so I'll go back to the very beginning, to My Own Commitment Sunday. My parents both being committed cynics, I hadn't been brought up as a churchgoer. And after many years searching, I finally joined a Christian church, and the rest, as they say, is history. That church happened to be of the Baptist denomination, so it was inevitable, really, that I would go towards baptism in July 1984. I was able to choose the Bible reading and the hymns for the service that morning. And not being familiar with many hymns, I went through the hymn book and found Thine Be the Glory. It was this that the minister then designated as the actual baptismal hymn, meaning that after verse 1, I was to leave the hymn book on the pew and make my way up to the platform. Immersion would take place after verse 2, and then after that I was to climb out of the baptistry and make my way to the vestry to dry and change, as they say in verse 3. I was rather disappointed because I wanted to actually sing the song, and I knew that without the hymn book I wouldn't know the words. However, when the moment came, I put down the book. I was able to continue singing as I walked up onto the platform and down into the water. The words just came to me. The same thing happened for verse 3. I was able to sing every word as I climbed out of the water and squelched out of the vestry. A memorable day, one which I relive often, particularly when I hear this song, number 152. And please could we stand to sing all three verses straight through with gusto.
Rehearsal, you will hear this prayer: Lord, remember those who once played or sang with us. We know that some of them are far from you. Some no longer serve you at all. Some serve you in other ways. We pray that at this moment they might know that we are thinking and praying for them. Those of you who have been in sections, how many times have you prayed that prayer? This morning we have an answer to prayer. For we pray, we ask God to return to us those who once served with us. And God sent Frank. She's here. Frankie, you are God's gift to us. Just as Christopher was an answer to prayer, so are you. Time to change a little. You're no longer going to be a songster. You're going to be a musician. That's not to say songsters weren't musicians. But the commission is now headed, Musicians Commission. As good stewards of the varied gifts given you by God. How wonderful on this commitment Sunday you're receiving this commission. Let each use the gift he has received in service to others. In all things let God be glorified through Jesus Christ. We thank God for you, for his answered prayer. We see you here. We regard you as a miracle. It's lovely to see you. It's my joy to be able to give to you your musician's commission. You are now a songster once again. Vernon is going to come and offer a prayer.
Heavenly Father, we just thank you this morning for your love, and because today we see your love, and we realise just how strong it is, and how that we can never really escape it. And for this answered prayer this morning, we give you praise. We pray that this will be perhaps happening on many more occasions, and we believe in your special way. So we thank you for Frankie this morning. We pray that you will strengthen her, that you will be there with her whenever she needs you in such so many ways. We pray that her service as a songster will bring her great joy, and we thank you that she is here to also bring great joy to us. So upon her and upon our gift, we ask your blessing.
And now, Frankie, you will help the songsters in singing to us, "Breathe on Me, Blessed God." twice already this morning. I'm saying again now, Eileen, you are God's answer to our prayer. For so long and so often we pray that he will send people to join with us in this Christian word life. And his answer to us this morning is you. We are so pleased we can recognise you as God's answer to our prayer. We have asked, and he has given. I see that you have brought your Aaron here this morning. Moses had his brother Aaron to speak for him. Ivy has Brenda. And it will become... Right, come forward please. You would love to hear all this.
Right, some while ago, Ivy came into the junior hall for the Sunday morning prayer meeting. On that occasion, the small chairs and mercy seat were arranged as Ivy remembered them when, as a child, she had attended Sunday school here. As a youngster, Ivy became a company guard, but as a teenager, drifted away. On that Sunday morning, when she saw the chairs and the mercy seat, Ivy felt she must fully commit herself to God, feeling God was giving her a second chance. Today we rejoice at God's safekeeping of Ivy over the years and her response to his second calling.
Did that say exactly what you wanted? You could almost say that yourself, couldn't you? Not everyone is a public speaker. Ivy says, and she's a good talker. But not publicly. You're not doing badly this morning. The years have gone, but the opportunities haven't. I don't know whether you can hear this exchange that we're having here, but Ivy is saying that she is so grateful that the opportunities have not gone. God never forgets us, does he? Not ever. He is a wonderful God. And on this Commitment Sunday, after all the years, we are delighted that you are standing here to be made a Salvation Army soldier. So am I, she says. Keep this up, is it good? All who wish to become soldiers of the Salvation Army are required to sign the Articles of War. In so doing, they testify that they worship God as Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. They have accepted Jesus Christ as Saviour and Lord. They desire to fulfil their membership with his church on earth as a soldier of the Salvation Army. They affirm their belief in the Bible as the Word of God and their acceptance of the Salvation Army's Articles of Faith. We pray for God to send somebody who would say that. And you are God's gift to us this morning. Ivy declares that she will be responsive to the Holy Spirit and seek to grow in grace, that she will make the values of the Kingdom of God the standard for her life, showing Christian integrity in her deeds, maintaining Christian ideals in her relationships, and upholding the sanctity of family life. She will be a faithful steward of all she has. She will abstain from the use of all enslaving substances and harmful activities. I think you've learned to do that by now. She will be active in God's work, both in sharing the gospel and in serving the needy, and will contribute financially to its support. I'm sure the Treasury will see you later. She will be true to the principles of the Salvation Army. I hardly need to ask, but I will. Do you declare in the presence of God and this congregation
that you undertake by the help of the Holy Spirit to live and work as a true soldier of Jesus Christ and of the Salvation Army, according to the witness and promises you make this day. If so, could you please raise your right hand and say, I do.
I do.
Wow. Did you hear that? We heard it, and we are so, so glad. Let us pray together. O God, our gracious Heavenly Father, we thank you for the evidence of answered prayer. We thank you that it is not a matter of years, but it is a matter of commitment. And on this commitment Sunday, we thank you for one who stands before you and us as a living testimony to a belief and to a trust in God. We thank you that Ivy has given her declarations, has made her promises, and is now relying on the grace of God to sustain her. We pray that she will know that she is surrounded by a praying company of God's people. And as we do so now, we ask that you will strengthen her and guide her and grant to her opportunities of introducing Jesus to others. We thank you for the way in which he has been brought to this point, and pray that now, as we stand on this holy ground, that we might all be aware of your presence. For we ask it in the name of Jesus. Amen. In the name of the Lord, whom we serve, I accept your declarations and receive you as a soldier of the Chatham Citadel Salvation Army. Read Ivy, please. too late, is it? Ivy has proved that. It's not too late. She won't mind me saying that she's 80 years old. It's not too late. If once you served in the Salvation Army band or some sense, not too late. But more importantly, it's not too late to serve God. Not just to be in the section. It's not too late. He leadeth me. It's not too late. We have asked so often, so long, we have asked God send to us people who will love him and serve him. Christopher this morning is an answer to prayer. Frankie is an answer to prayer. Ivy is an answer to prayer. Are you an answer to prayer? Mercy seat here is open for you. He leadeth me. Let him lead you this morning. His words are more persuasive than any that I have. commitment will result from that commitment. God is at work.
Amen.
We praise him. We praise him. We praise him. The effectiveness of your decision, Ivy, was justified this morning. We praise him for you and we thank God for you. Let us pray. And now, O God, accept our praise and our thanks. We marvel at your workings in our lives and in this call. We thank you that you are leading us, and for the three gifts, now four, that you have given to us this morning, our hearts rejoice. Thank you for the evidence of answered prayer. And now may the grace of God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit be with you all now and forevermore. Amen. I'm going to ask Ivy.